Namaskar, hello and welcome to NCRT's live phone-in program. My name is Tanvi Khurana and in this session of maths, we're going to understand the concept of polynomials. And this is the first part of this topic. If you have any questions, please feel free to send it on our email ID, which is dth.class10@ciet.nic.in. I repeat the email ID, it's dth.class10@ciet.nic.in. All the 10th class students, you're here with us so that you can understand the concept and learn the topic and along with it, ask your doubts, ask your queries. You're watching us on PM eVidya channel number 10 and also on our YouTube channel NCERT Official. In the live chat box of that YouTube channel, you can write down your questions, queries. So there are various methods through which you can reach us. And if you want to know the schedule of our programs, our timetable, which subject is and with which class, with which topic is about to begin, when. So all these details are mentioned on our website in the schedule of CIET and Swayamprabha. So open these websites and please have access to these information. We have an expert with us and she'll be, of course, giving us details about polynomials. So let's meet her. She is Ms. Savita Graak. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you, Tanvi, and a very good afternoon to all of our viewers.
Good afternoon to you too, ma'am. Ma'am is a teacher from Gita Niketan Avasiya Vidyalaya Kurukshetra. So let's ask her that what is it that we are going to learn in this particular session of polynomials. Ma'am, over to you.
Okay, right. So the topic for today, it is polynomials. Polynomials is, of course, not a very new topic to our viewers, as they have already studied about the topic polynomials in their class 9. In class 9, we have studied about various types of polynomials. And what do we mean by polynomials we have gone through? But today we are going to discuss much more about polynomials. We will see that how can we present a polynomial on a graph. And after presenting a polynomial on a graph, we will also see some examples that how polynomials are helpful to us in our real lives. And which are the shapes which remind us about different type of polynomials from our daily lives. So first of all, let us define polynomials. What do we mean by a polynomial? A polynomial is, of course, an algebraic expression. Now, what do we mean by algebraic expression? Dear viewers, when you were in class 5th, you have studied about 45 plus 96 or 45 multiplied by 38 or some division questions were there. But when you have entered to your class 6th, there was a topic algebraic expression. And since then, you are studying about various types of variables, constants, and exponents as well. So what do we mean by variables? For example, I say that I have some amount in my hand and I'm not telling you that I have 100 rupees there or 500 or 2000 or 50. So you people might be guessing there can be 2 rupees, there can be 5 rupees, there can be 100. 500, 5000 or whatsoever. So this is a variable for you up to when I will not open my hand. Of course, at this time, I'm not having even a single pen in my hand. So we have variable. Variable means the value which we do not know, we consider it as a variable and this variable can be written as variable X or variable Y or variable Z or variable T in various questions. And some constants will be there. Constants is, of course, a value. For example, 2, 3, 5, 1 upon 2, under root 2, which value is static? Jo change nahi hoti, that is known as constant value. And exponents, of course, some powers will be there. For example, I am mentioning here, I have taken here 5 examples. Out of these, some are polynomials and some are not. Let us check that which of these are polynomials. The very first, I have written 2x plus 5. Now, what do we mean by 2x plus 5? This is an expression in which x is presenting a variable, 5 is a constant and 2 is the coefficient of x. And what is the degree of x? Since there is no power mentioned here, so the degree of x will be considered as 1. So this is a polynomial. Let us read it completely. An algebraic expression in which the exponent of any variable is a whole number. Whole number, we know it very well, that the powers or the numbers starting from 0 and these are endless are known as whole numbers. So variable ki jo power hai, that must be a whole number. Otherwise jo constant term hai, that can have a negative power, that can be there in the form of a fraction, that can be there in the form of a decimal. For example, let us see our second part. Here y is a variable and the highest power of y is 2. Then the next term for this expression is minus 5y, and the power of this y is 1, and this is 7. 7 is a constant value. What do you mean by constant value? There is no variable along with it. That means y raised to the power 0 can be mentioned here. As we know it very well, that something raised to the power 0 is always equals to 1. And 7 can be written as 7 into 1. So it is only 7. So again, the power of variable y is a whole number. Therefore, this is also a polynomial. Now, what about this third part? In this third part, x is a variable. In the first term, the power of x is 3, which is a whole number. In the second term, the power of x is 1. Okay, if no power will be written, that means the power is 1. So again, 1 is a whole number. And the third term is 1 upon 5. But along with it, we can say that the variable's power is 0. So the power of variable is either 3 or 1 or it is 0. So it is also a polynomial. We should not be worried about under root 7 or 1 upon 5 because both of these values are constants. Or constant kisi bhi form mein ho sakta hai. Lekin dhyan rakhne wali baat ye hai ki variable ki power just and only a whole number can be there. Now let us see this fourth example. Here in the first term, it is 2x square, 2, a whole number, that is okay. But in the second term, it is under root x. And we know that the meaning of this is x raised to the power 1 by 2. That means x, the power of x is not a whole number. Therefore, this expression is not a polynomial. Similarly, in the next case, we can say that this is a rational expression, which is 5 upon 3x minus 2. And since the variable is at the denominator, therefore its power becomes negative. So it is not a polynomial. So after discussing about what do we mean by a polynomial, let's discuss about what is the degree of a polynomial. It's very, very, very simple. What is degree of a polynomial? It is the largest exponent of the variable is the degree of that particular polynomial. We have taken here three examples. The very first example, what is the largest degree of the variable? Here we can say it is x or x raised to the power 1. Along with 5, it is x raised to the power 0. Therefore, what is the degree of this polynomial? The degree of this polynomial is 1. Similarly, in the second part, what is the highest power? It is 2. Therefore, the degree of this polynomial is 2. And in the third part, what is the degree? Degree here is, it is 3. Because 3 is the highest power of the variable x. So, if I am writing 2 raised to the power 100 into x raised to the power 5, plus 7. So what is the degree of this polynomial? The degree of this polynomial is undoubtedly 5. It cannot be 100. Because 100 is presenting here the power of a constant value. Okay? That means 2 into 2 into 2. But we have to see the exponent of the variable only, not the exponent of the constant value. So let us discuss now about various types of polynomials on the basis of degree itself. हमने सीखा कि डिग्री कहते किसे हैं, तो उसी के बेस पर अभी हम डिफाइन करते हैं फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अ लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय अ लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल? सी, अ लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल इज अ पॉलिनोमियल ऑफ डिग्री वन. सिंपली इफ आई एम राइटिंग 3 - 5x, वेदर इट इज अ पॉलिनोमियल? सो आर आंसर इज येस, बिकॉज द पावर ऑफ वेरिएबल हियर इज 1. एंड इट is linear polynomial. The reason is the highest power, or we can say the degree of the polynomial is 1 here. So किसी भी polynomial की degree अगर 1 है तो उसे हम बोलते हैं linear polynomial. और एक और चीज साथ ही आपको बताएं कि अगर आप किसी भी linear polynomial को graph पर उसको geometrically show करना चाहते हो तो what type of shape will be formed there? It will be a line. Linear, the first 4 alphabets of this word, L-I-N-E. So if we will try to represent a linear polynomial of a graph, it will form a line. And after linear polynomial, let us discuss about a quadratic polynomial. A polynomial whose highest degree, or I must say whose highest power is 2, whose degree is 2, is known as a quadratic polynomial. Let us take an example of a quadratic polynomial. If I'm writing ax square plus bx plus c, and along with it, it is a must to mention that a is not equals to 0. That means the highest power of x here is 2 and its coefficient is a. So this a should not be 0. क्योंकि अगर ये a 0 हो जाएगा तो हमारी ये complete term ही omit हो जाएगी, खत्म हो जाएगी, और उसके बाद जो polynomial बचता है that is bx plus c which is linear. So अगर हम quadratic polynomial लिख रहे हैं, we must be aware कि degree 2 का जो coefficient है that will not be 0. After this, let us discuss about a cubic polynomial. नाम से ही clear है, a polynomial whose degree is 3. Let us write an example for the same. It is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, where a, b, c and d are the constants, or we can say a is the coefficient of x square, b is the coefficient of a is the coefficient of x cube, b is the coefficient of x square, c is the coefficient of x, and d is the constant term here. Again, the condition is that the coefficient of x cube should not be 0. All other coefficients, b or c or d, these can be 0, these can be anything else, but a cannot be 0. The next one is biquadratic, or we can also say it as quartic polynomial. Of course, hum degree wise chal rahe hain, so a polynomial whose degree is 4 is known as a biquadratic polynomial. If I am writing a into x raised to the power 4, this time the highest power of x is 4, plus bx cube plus cx square plus dx plus e, where a is not equals to 0, this is known as a biquadratic polynomial. Similarly, what do we mean by a constant polynomial? This is an interesting one. पहली बात तो हम आपको बताएं that किसी भी polynomial को we can write as p of x, polynomial of x, or g of x, or h of x. Okay, in this way we can present any of our polynomial. और अगर हम बात करते हैं constant polynomial की, तो a polynomial whose degree is 0 is known as a constant polynomial. If I'm writing p of x equals to 5, only a constant value is there, variable hai hi nahi. So variable na hone ka seedha sa matlab kya hai? It can be written as 5 into 1, or it can be written as 5 into x raised to the power 0. Therefore, the degree of a constant polynomial is always 0. If I am writing p of x equals to under root 7, or 1/5, or 1.3. So these all are also the examples of a constant polynomial. Variable will not be there. Now the next is very important, zero polynomial. What is a zero polynomial? if the constant polynomial is nothing else than zero, means if the polynomial is only and only zero, p of x equals to zero, or we have written here f of x equals to zero. So in this case, the polynomial will be known as a zero polynomial. Clear? और वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन इज दिस. यहाँ से वन मार्क का हमारा एक क्वेश्चन बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट निकल कर सामने आता है. व्हाट इज दैट? व्हाट इज द डिग्री ऑफ अ जीरो पॉलिनोमियल? अभी तक हमने जितने पॉलिनोमियल्स डिस्कस किए, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द डिग्रीज, बट हियर आई हैव नॉट मेंशन द डिग्री विच इज नॉट डिफाइंड. द डिग्री ऑफ अ जीरो पॉलिनोमियल इज नॉट डिफाइंड. व्हाई सो? बिकॉज दिस इज ओनली एंड ओनली जीरो. And we know that 0 can also be written as 0 into x square. It can also be written as 0 into x cube. It can also be written as 0 into x raised to the power 31 or 300 or whatsoever. That means the power of x does not matter here, because 0 multiplied by something always becomes 0. That is why the degree is not defined. Now, after this, totally different. Zero polynomial and zero of a polynomial. These are two different values. Now we are discussing about zero of a polynomial. Class 9th में हमने ये topic बहुत अच्छे से cover किया है, but we are taking an example so that थोड़ा सा आपको remind हो जाए कि हमने किया क्या था. A real number alpha is said to be a zero of the polynomial f of x if f of alpha equals to zero. Simply, in place of x, we have to put this value alpha, and on putting the value of x to be alpha, if we are getting that f of alpha is zero, in that case, that particular value alpha is known as the zero of the given polynomial. So, ek example ke through hum dekhte hain. Here we have taken a polynomial f of x, which is x square plus x minus 2, and we have to calculate two values, f of 1 and f of minus 2. So, how to calculate f of 1? For calculating f of 1, we will put x to be 1. Thus, it is 1 square in place of x. It is 1, then again 1 minus 2. And we have 2 minus 2, which is undoubtedly 0. Now, let us calculate the second part's value. What it is, in the second part, we can see that we have to calculate f of minus 2. In place of x, simply we will put the value minus 2, and we are getting this time positive 4, negative 2 and negative 2. Again, we have 4 minus 4 equals to 0. So, we will say that both of these values, x equals to 1 and x equals to minus 2, both of these values are the zeros of given polynomial. But if I want to calculate anything else, if I am calculating f of 3, so what I will get this time? I will be getting 3 square, which is 9, plus 3 minus 2, which is of course 10. 12 minus 2 is 10, and 10 is not equals to 0. That's why we will say that x equals to 3 is not a zero of given polynomial. तो x की जिस वैल्यू के लिए हमारा पॉलिनोमियल कंप्लीटली जीरो हो जाता है, दैट वैल्यू विल बी नॉन एज द जीरो ऑफ द गिवन पॉलिनोमियल. नाउ आफ्टर दिस वी आर डिस्कसिंग सम इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स. द वेरी फर्स्ट ऑफ दीज इज अ लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल हैज एग्जैक्टली वन जीरो. सी दिस एग्जांपल अगेन. विच टाइप ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल इज दिस? हाईएस्ट डिग्री इज 2, देयरफॉर दिस इज अ क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल. So it must be clear to us that if a polynomial is quadratic, then number of zeros will be at most 2. Now, why I'm using this word at most? Let us discuss it. A linear polynomial has exactly one zero. If I am writing a linear x minus 7, then for which value of x this expression will become zero? It is 7. अगर हम x को 7 पुट करते हैं, देन द एक्सप्रेशन इज बिकमिंग 0. देयरफॉर x इक्वल्स टू 7 इज अ 0 ऑफ दिस पॉलिनोमियल. बट फॉर अ क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल एट मोस्ट 2 जीरोस विल बी देयर. एट मोस्ट मींस देयर कैन बी 1 जीरो इवन. अगर हम एक एक्सप्रेशन लिखते हैं x माइनस थ्री होल स्क्वायर, क्यूबिक पॉलिनोमियल हैज एट मोस्ट थ्री जीरोस, यानी सीधा सा कनेक्शन डिग्री के साथ है. इफ द डिग्री इज थ्री देन द नंबर ऑफ जीरोस विल बी थ्री. इफ द डिग्री इज टू देन द नंबर ऑफ मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ जीरोस विल बी टू. एंड इफ द डिग्री इज एन, इफ वी हैव अ पॉलिनोमियल ऑफ डिग्री एन देन इट हैज एट मोस्ट एन जीरोस. और इसके साथ ही दिस पॉइंट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. व्हाट इट इज, इफ अ रियल नंबर अल्फा अ जीरो ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल एफ एक्स देन एक्स माइनस अल्फा इज द फैक्टर ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर पॉलिनोमियल. यानी कि अगर एफ ऑफ एक्स इक्वल्स टू एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस थ्री एक्स प्लस टू, ये हमारे पास पॉलिनोमियल है और x को 1 पुट करने पर वी कैन सी कि ये एक्सप्रेशन जो है दिस इज बिकमिंग 0. दैट इज व्हाई x इक्वल्स टू 1 इज अ 0 ऑफ दिस पॉलिनोमियल. एंड इन दिस केस अगर हम 1 को ड्रैग करते हैं लेफ्ट साइड पर ले जाते हैं तो इट इज x माइनस 1 विल बिकम अ फैक्टर ऑफ गिवन पॉलिनोमियल. फैक्टर मींस अगर हम x माइनस 1 से f of x को डिवाइड करते हैं तो रिमाइंडर विल बी नथिंग एल्स देन जीरो. एंड इट इज द टाइम टू सॉल्व अ क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन द कॉन्सेप्ट्स व्हिच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड टिल. इफ x प्लस 1 इज अ फैक्टर ऑफ x स्क्वायर माइनस 3kx प्लस, यानी कि दिस इज अ क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल. अगर इस क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल का एक फैक्टर है x प्लस 1, सो वी हैव टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ k. तो जैसा अभी हमने लास्ट पॉइंट डिस्कस किया था, इफ x प्लस 1 इज अ फैक्टर ऑफ गिवन पॉलिनोमियल, लेट अस सपोज दिस पॉलिनोमियल टू बी p ऑफ x, देन व्हाट कैन वी से अबाउट जीरो ऑफ दिस पॉलिनोमियल. इफ वी आर पुटिंग x प्लस 1 इक्वल्स टू 0 देन x इक्वल्स टू माइनस 1, दिस इज 0 ऑफ द पॉलिनोमियल. And if this is a zero of given polynomial, therefore p of minus 1, it is equals to 0. And p of minus 1 means complete polynomial mein, if we are putting the value of x to be minus 1, so it is minus 1 square minus 3k into in place of x, humne x ki value yahan par put ki. And on solving it, we are able to get the value of k, and we can see from here that the value of k is 1. So this one is an important question according to examination of point of view as well. And has the time to discuss the geometrical meaning or geometrical representation of zeros of a polynomial. Just before this I have discussed about the zero of a linear polynomial. This is a graph, and this is the graph of the polynomial y equals to 5x plus 5. Highest degree of x is 1 here, so we can say that this is a linear polynomial. So, अभी हमने discuss भी किया था कि linear polynomial की जो हम graphical presentation करते हैं, it will always present a line. So, it is a line here. And this line is intersecting x-axis at exactly one point, and this point is minus 5, 0. Clear? So, agar hamara polynomial hai y equals to p of x, and the polynomial is not given to us. Agar polynomial aapko given hoga, to aap bata sakte hain ki cubic polynomial ke liye at most 3 zeros hain. But this time, graphical presentation will be given to us, and polynomial will not be given. Hame sirf graph ko dekh kar hi judge karna hai that what is the number of zeros for this particular polynomial.
Okay.
So here I am discussing about the zeros of quadratic as well as cubic polynomials. First of all, this is the graphical presentation of any polynomial. But ये पॉलिनोमियल एक्स एक्सिस को कितने पॉइंट्स पर कट करता है. वी कैन से दैट दिस इज इंटरसेक्टिंग द एक्स एक्सिस एट एग्जैक्टली टू पॉइंट्स एंड द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज -1, 0, द सेकेंड पॉइंट इज 2, 0. डियर व्यूअर्स, अभी आपको बताया गया है कि इफ y इक्वल्स टू p ऑफ x कोई भी पॉलिनोमियल है तो x की वो वैल्यू जिस वैल्यू के लिए p ऑफ x 0 बन जाएगा दैट वैल्यू ऑफ x विल बी नॉन एज इट्स 0. ओके, तो आपको पता है कि इफ दिस इज x एक्सिस तो x एक्सिस की इक्वेशन क्या होती है, इट इज y इक्वल्स टू 0. दैट मींस कंप्लीट x एक्सिस पर वैल्यू ऑफ y इज ऑलवेज 0. तो दिस पॉइंट इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग -1, 0, यानी इस पॉइंट के लिए वैल्यू ऑफ x इज -1 एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ y इज 0. सिमिलरली फॉर दिस पॉइंट वैल्यू ऑफ x इज 2 एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ y इट इज 0. यानी कि हमें दो ऐसे पॉइंट मिल गए गिवन कर्व के लिए जिस पर y इक्वल्स टू 0 आ रहा है. तो दिस पॉलिनोमियल हैज एग्जैक्टली 2 0. ओके, एंड दिस शेप जो हमें ये यू टाइप जो शेप दिखाई दे रही है दिस इज नॉन एज पैराबोला. कोई भी क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल को हम पैराबोलिक फॉर्म में पैराबोलिक शेप में शो कर सकते हैं और बहुत सारे पैराबोलास हम अपने रियल लाइफ में भी देखते हैं. थोड़ा सा आप दिमाग दौड़ाते रहिए कि कौन कौन सी शेप्स आपके माइंड में आती हैं और कुछ शेप्स हम भी अभी डिस्कस जरूर करें. सो नेक्स्ट इज क्यूबिक पॉलिनोमियल. कैसे पता चलता है, वैसे तो इन दीज वेरी फर्स्ट सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल्स मैंने मेंशन किया है पॉलिनोमियल, अदरवाइज कैसे पता चलता है ग्राफ को देखकर. सी दिस इज द फर्स्ट पॉइंट, दिस इज -2, 0, x is negative 2, y is 0. This is the second point. Of course, x is something negative 0.3 and y is 0 क्योंकि complete x-axis पर y is 0 रहेगा. And this is 3, 0. So how many zeros are there? There are 3 zeros exactly. Now here is an exercise for you all. फटाफट से अगर chat box में हमारे viewers जुड़े रहते तो बता सकते थे. So this curve or this line is intersecting the x-axis at exactly 1.0 is there. Intersecting the x-axis at exactly 2 points, therefore 2 zeros. This will be presenting a cubic polynomial, that is a 3 zeros. And similarly, here are some questions for our viewers. You have to solve these. You have to enjoy solving these all questions. Okay, and now it's the time to see some of the parabolas in our real life. So banana bahut routine mein hum sab dekhte hai na, there is a fruit banana. Shape kya ja rahi hai, this is a quadratic function. If we are throwing a ball in the basket, again the shape is parabolic. हमने कितनी बार ब्रिज क्रॉस किया है और ब्रिज और रिवर के बीच में जो ब्रिज को बनाने का स्टाइल रहता है दैट इज पैराबोलिक. दिस इज अ स्विंग हैविंग शोइंग अस वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ कर्व्स. अगेन द शेप इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय पॉलिनोमियल्स. मैकडॉनल्ड्स जाते हैं आप सभी, कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू पैराबोलास. और अगर हम इसे इस तरह से देखते हैं सो वी कैन से के यस, ये जो सभी शेप्स हैं अगर हम इन सभी शेप्स में एक एक्स एक्सिस और एक वाई एक्सिस ड्रॉ कर देते हैं और फिर यहाँ पर कोई जनरल पॉइंट लेट अस टेक इट इज एक्स वाई और जनरल पॉइंट के थ्रू इक्वेशन निकालने की कोशिश करते हैं दैट इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ पैराबोलाइड. तो हमारी रियल लाइफ में ही सब कुछ हमारे आसपास है. इवन जब आप वाटरिंग द प्लांट्स करते हो ना, ऐसा आप फन में अगर जब पाइप हाथ में पकड़ते हो और वो पानी का जो फ्लो जाता है जो डायरेक्शन वो पकड़ रहा है दैट इज अ पैराबोला अगेन. सो नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, इट इज रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन जीरो एंड कोफिशिएंट्स ऑफ अ लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल. ऑफ कोर्स तन्वी, वी विल डिस्कस दिस टॉपिक इन डेप्थ इन आवर नेक्स्ट सेशन. आई कैन सी द एक्सप्रेशंस ऑन योर फेस, बट वी आर जस्ट discussing a little bit about it today.
Sure, ma'am.
So it is relationship between the zeros and coefficients. Here I am discussing the linear polynomial. Okay. If I'm writing f of x equals to ax plus b, This is a linear polynomial. And what can we say about the number of zeros for it? Since it is linear, so it has just and only one zero. And let us suppose that it has only one zero. And let us suppose that zero to be alpha. And what will be the value of alpha? अगर हम पुट करते हैं अपने पॉलिनोमियल को जीरो के इक्वल, सो वी आर गेटिंग एक्स इक्वल्स टू माइनस बी अपॉन ए. सो ओनली वन वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स कैन बी देयर फॉर विच दिस पॉलिनोमियल इज बिकमिंग जीरो. देयरफॉर इट हैज ओनली वन जीरो एंड दैट वन जीरो इक्वल्स टू माइनस बी अपॉन ए.
ओके मैम, क्या हम अपना सेशन यहीं पे इसी नोट पे खत्म करें एंड वी विल कंटिन्यू इट इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन?
राइट, देन वी कैन स्टॉप इट हियर एंड वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द रिलेशनशिप ऑफ द जीरोस एंड कोफिशिएंट्स ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक एंड क्यूबिक पॉलीनोमियल इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन. नाउ आई होप दैट इफ द स्टूडेंट्स विल बी हैविंग एनी प्रॉब्लम दे विल डिस्कस इट विद अस. थैंक यू.
Absolutely. So they'll be sharing their questions because polynomials is a big it's a big topic. So you'll be doing it in parts and they'll be sending their questions also in parts. So let's wait for their questions in the next session. And for now, let's wrap it up here. Thank you so much, ma'am, for the concept, for clearing the concept of polynomials, although there's yet to come. Thank you.
Thank you, Tanvi. Thanks to our viewers.
Thank you to all the viewers. Please watch this session. It will be uploaded on our YouTube channel, NCERT Official. You can watch it again and again. And part two will be coming soon. So keep your questions ready. Coming up next is a social science class for all the class 10th students, where we are going to discuss nationalism in Europe. And this will be the third part of the same topic. Stay with us. Don't go anywhere. Keep on watching PME Vidya channel number 10. Thank you once again. Namaste.